Andy Teodoro, welcome. Thanks for making the time. You are both very heavily involved in the Braceoff project. Can you tell me a little bit what the Braceoff project is about?
So thank you very much for having us. So the Braceoff project is about breeding for resilient, efficient and sustainable organic vegetables. And the aim is to increase the competitiveness of these vegetables under low input conditions. And the project is focusing on the three most economically important crops in Europe. So tomatoes, snap bean and brassicas, mostly broccoli in this case. And the project is a 5-year project funded under the Horizon 2020 Research and Innovation Program. And in total, 22 partners are involved in a multi-actor approach.
Yeah, the Braceoff actually project is organized in 4 work packages. Okay. And one is about the pre-breeding, so characterization of materials and also researchers aiming to understand the genetic basis of traits involved in organic production. Then there is a breeding work package aiming to produce new materials with improved resilience. And then there is a work package involved in the seed production aspects, both for quantity and quality. Mm-hmm. And the last one is for aims to recommend new varieties to farmers. So there is a multi-location testing of the varieties, both produced within the project and also general varieties for organic farmers. That is a very comprehensive
approach. Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. I understand. But tell me, why was it necessary to start this project?
Yes, so the European Union launched a quite ambitious program with the Green Deal and Farm to Farm strategy to transform the European agri-food system. And so until 2030, the goal is to reach 25% of land that is organically managed, also to significantly reduce the pesticide use, fertilizer use in agriculture. So that's quite a challenge. And so in 2020, we had 9.1% of the utilized land under organic production. So still some way to go. And also organic production is quite knowledge intensive. And this is where research projects can step in and support in this development.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Yeah, I mean, the project has, I should say, some general concept of sustainability that today, nowadays are very important. But for organic agriculture specifically, there are some issues related to management of diversity and varieties, to incorporation of tolerance traits for biotic stresses or biotic stresses. In general, what is important is to have varieties that are selected on organic fields, and so they are adapted to those conditions, and that is what we are doing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, sure. A very important target in relation to Green Deal and Farm to Fork,
sure,
obviously.
Sure.
Yeah,
because also there is a productivity issue, you know, with organic agriculture, productivity gap, that is important to
keep in mind. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I know the project is not yet finished. You're close to finalization, I believe, next year, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Can you already share some achievements so far?
We got quite many results because in the 3 crops, some results were related to information. I mean, we now knew more than we now know what we knew at the beginning of the project in relation to the genes, QTL, controlling traits that are important for performance in organic conditions. We have also we have information about the effect of low input conditions on, for example, on quality for some crops. Mm-hmm. And also we have materials that have now resistance to stresses in tomato. We have genotypes that are resistant to fusarium or to some viruses. So this is very important, especially for organic agriculture, where you don't have alternative systems that you can to combat these pathogens.
Yeah,
so.
Sure.
So resistance is a main issue.
Yeah, I can imagine.
Another focus was also on, as Theodor already said, so increasing the amount of organically produced seeds and also the quality. Mm-hmm. And so there we also had extensive experiments and field trials all over Europe, and we're testing different agronomic conditions. So plant density or plant growth promoting microbials, for example, also so foliar fertilization of plants. So there we are also expecting to have at the end a best practice recommendation for organic seed production and also so the lines that were tested on the farm to see which lines are locally adapted or also over regionally adapted.
Yeah, interesting. But you have to explain me one thing. You mentioned already the yield gap, and this is something that is used by critics of organic agriculture as one of the big barriers to organic agriculture. What's your take on this? Can organic agriculture feed the planet?
Yeah, so I think that's a tough question. So what we saw in us, also in our experiments, so it's not easy to produce seeds in organic conditions. So that's really, so this yield gap is there. So the challenges with pests and diseases, environmental challenges. Besides that, organic production can give also positive input to agriculture, European agriculture, regarding lower input conditions and also ecosystem services. So at the end, I think it will be the need to combine the best out of different worlds to yield this sustainability goal that we are aiming at.
Yeah, I agree fully, because probably organic agriculture gave an impulse to some issues that is very important. But I'm not sure if we can use organic agriculture everywhere for every crop, for every destination of the products and so on. So probably a combination of different systems and a wise choice every time is probably the best. And also, the productivity gap, and also the fact that now there are these climatic changes that are pushing for solution very quickly. So I think that it would be good that probably sometimes I don't understand that organic breeding for organic. There are some people say that when you breed for organic agriculture, you cannot use some technologies. I'm not just talking about new technologies, but also all the ones that are very important, that have been tested and validated for a long time. And I think that probably that would be not a good choice to leave out these technologies, because we need the solutions and we need all the tools that we have.
Absolutely. I think there you say something very important. With all the challenges that we have, we need all the tools and all the innovation that we can get our hands on. Thank you so much, Emily and
Thank you.